Hey everybody, it's Geoff Short with CHAUVET DJ here again with my friend Rick Peeples, product manager. Rick, how are you?
I'm fine, Geoff. How are you doing today?
I'm fantastic, thank you. We're here today to talk to you about IP and what does that mean in regards to the line of CHAUVET DJ products. So Rick, I think the first thing that people ought to know is what IP stands for.
IP stands for ingress protection. This is the ability or inability for a fixture or any type of unit to keep things in from getting in it and getting out of it.
Excellent. So as you guys know, we have a number of IP rated fixtures because as time goes on, it becomes more and more important for products to have the versatility to be used indoors or out. So IP ratings become very important. But there's a little bit of confusion between the number rating system and what that means. So first of all, in context of DJ products, what IP ratings are we talking about?
Well, in the DJ brand, we started at IP20, which is actually an indoor fixture, so you cannot use it outside. Pretty much your toaster is IP20. Everything is IP20 rated. That's where it starts. It goes all the way up to IP68, which is actually a submersible fixture. In DJ, we've had some IP43 products. Currently in production are IP54 and IP65 items.
So the 54 would mean what?
The first number is dust and particles.
Okay.
The bigger the number, the smaller the particle. 6 theoretically shouldn't allow any dust to get into the unit.
Okay.
The second digit is your water protection. 0 meaning 0, 8 meaning more. When you get into the 43 spectrum, which is the original festoons had, that means that the actual fixture has to be in a particular orientation because the water can only come at it from a certain angle at a certain force. If you flipped it over, it would lose its IP protection. Mm-hmm. IP54, such as the Freedom Gobo and the Flex here, they can take water from any direction. Now, this doesn't mean you can pressure wash these fixtures because there's pressure and depth associated with the second number. So 54, rainwater, sprinklers, things like that will not affect these units. You can't pressure clean it.
Normal conditions, if you were at a special event and it was raining,
exactly,
or snowing, or there was going to get mud splashed on them, then 54 would be fine. And
absolutely perfect.
That's what these two fixtures are. This is the Freedom Gobo IP and the Freedom Flex H4 IP. And then this one here is the Slim Panel Tri-24, which is a 64 rated IP fixture.
IP65.
Excellent. So we can see here that some of the features are real giveaways in terms of a fixture being IP rated or not. For instance, I see that the connections here have certain caps, and I can see that there's certain caps on the backs of fixtures. And how does that work?
That's your ingress protection on the cables. With the Slim Panel 24, it's an older fixture. It still runs pigtails, but you can see you have to put a cap on the end. If you don't put the cap on the end, the water can get in there and cause short circuits and problems with your DMX line. On the Freedom Gobo, the charge port has a plug. Some of the newer fixtures in our Pro division that use newer connectors will have rubber flaps on the back of the unit. You have to close these flaps in order to get the IP protection. If they're open, it's just like having a hole in the unit.
Excellent. So the one thing that we get questions on a lot is will the fixture perform in ideal ways when water gets either in the fixture or on top of the fixture or can pool on top of the fixture? What are the expectations of the performance of an IP rated fixture when it's wet and when there's water involved? Because there's a difference between the fixture actually being protected and the fixture performing ideally when it's wet.
That's a real good question, Geoff. And I have a few answers because even on wash lights, which don't image, if this particular unit were to be laying flat, the water would pool on top. It acts like a secondary lens, so you would see some rippling and you'd see changes in your beam pattern. The IP protection means that the unit can survive. It can get wet. You'll be able to use it at your next dig. It's not gonna have a problem. It's not gonna cause harm, injury to anybody. With things like a Gobo projector, you have a slot in the top. Water can get in here. It will not harm the unit. You can pour water all over this. It's not going to hurt the unit. But like rain on your windshield, it's going to affect the vision that you see that's projected from the gobo. So with this particular unit, if I knew I was gonna mount it in a rainy environment, and you know your wedding's probably gonna stop under a torrential downpour, but slight drizzle and things like that, the show must go on. I would intentionally mount it this way. That way when the rain hits it, it doesn't slide into that adjustment slot and cover my optics. Nothing's gonna be perfect in a rainstorm, but the units will survive.
And I think that's the key. And it's about managing expectations when conditions are not ideal in inclement weather conditions. And with the Freedom Gobo IP, you absolutely can invert it without the gobo falling out because the gobo holder is actually magnetic. So it's designed to do exactly that and be inverted if necessary. But even if it's not inverted, as Rick said, with water getting in there, there's no harm to the fixture itself. But you do have to manage your expectations, and if you see sort of a weird visual effect happening, that's what water does. And as you said, it's a secondary lens. Excellent. So that's just a little overview in terms of what IP ratings mean and what they mean for the fixtures in terms of the DJ line. If you have any other questions, be sure and get in touch with us, chauvetdj.com, and we'll put a little description of what these IP ratings mean in the description of this video as well. In the meantime, we thank you for watching. Rick, thank you for the great information, and we'll see you next time.